There we go. It should be up now. I must have clicked the wrong button here in the right there in the OBS studio. Everybody should be able to hear me now. And yep, I'm back. My hair's getting so darn long. So what we're gonna do first, and let's see here, side view. We have got a block of maple similar to this. And what I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna take a bowl gouge. It's a 5/8 or a 1/2 inch bowl gouge, and I'm gonna turn it round. My handy Jimmy Clues Doug Thompson lathe tool. Get this up and running here in a second. You guys can hear me all right now, right? I hope so. I tend to turn these a little fast. It makes it a lot easier to cut the corners off. And I got it about 1800 RPMs. And by the way, this is my first live YouTube. I've done some Zoom demos and I've done a whole lot of live club demos. So this should be an interesting day for me and you, I hope. And I hope I can give you guys some more information about making ornaments that you don't already know. You almost got it down to square. Let me switch the, let's try that one. Maybe you guys get a better look at what I'm doing. Got it nice and round. Oh, that's a really pretty piece of burl. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move my tool rest around onto an angle. And I'm going to start the first part. It's sort of like making a very large bead. I'm going to lower my tool rest just a hair. There we go. You guys see me all right, or am I blocking you guys? All right, here we go. I think, oh, dang, that is. I thought you guys would be able to see that better. Sorry, I'm just adjusting camera stuff. Where'd you go? Give me 1 second here. I'm new at this. There you are. Come back around this way here. That should be a good shot for you guys. All right, back to it. Let's make a very large bead here. I'm holding my tool at about a 45 degree angle. And I'm going to bring the tool rest in just a little bit closer. Wow, I'm just blocking that whole thing, aren't I? Let's try another view here. All right, side view and overhead view. That should work. Do a little bit of a cleanup turn here. All right, so you guys can see what's going on the back side. I turned it over to the overhead. Pretty much the same thing, just the opposite. I also have a glue block similar to this on this one, and I'm just going to cut away that as I get down a little further, but I'm not going to take too much off because I still need to hollow out the piece. Boy, this delay in YouTube, boy, it throws you off. It's like a 5-minute lag time between, 5 seconds between what I do and then what you guys see. I'm just gonna do a nice little shear cut there and get the shape in. Same on the front. So I'm going to switch over to the side view camera here. We're pretty much done for that right now. You can tell it's taking up a nice little shape there. And right now I need to take a parting tool, put a little point right in there so I can drill it out and the drill bit won't wander around. That'll work. So we're gonna move the tool rest out of the way, bring up my tailstock. And the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a little 5/8 drill bit. It's got the wrong chuck in there. In here, and we're just going to drill this part way down, and then we'll take a smaller bit and we're going to drill all the way through, and I'll show you in a little bit why I do two different size holes. There we go. Bring this up, turn down the speed. There we go. We don't want to go too fast with a Forstner bit here. As you can see, I got a little piece of tape on there now, just to make sure I don't go too far in. That'll work. Yeah, we're going to take a little 3/8 inch bit and finish drilling all the way through. And that Forstner bit left a little dimple in the bottom of the hole, so the drill bit will find its target and work its way through. And you'll be able to hear when once you break through the other end here. There we go. Somebody needs to invent a tail stock that has a lock release so you don't have to crank this so much. Back it out. That out of there. Let's see what's going on. A lot of hellos in the chat. Very nice. So as you can see, I've got a hole cut in there. And that's where we're going to start doing our hollowing out. Fix this a little bit here. Shaving is lots of fun. And what I have here is a Mike Jagoski rocket tool, hollowing tool with a number one hunter bit on there. It makes it really easy to hollow out small items like this. So I want to make sure I'm close enough. I got the tool rest at the right height. Needs to go up a little higher. Now, when it comes to hollowing these things, I'm not really too concerned about wall thickness. The idea here is just to lighten the wood. You want to make the ornament as light as possible. Wow, I thought I had it the first time. There we go. You're all set to go. I'm going to turn it up a little bit here. Right at about 17. I'm not really too concerned about the speed, actually. It's just whatever sounds and feels comfortable. So I'm going to start in doing some front cuts here just to clear it out. You start towards this end and work your way towards the bottom with the chisel. And you want to leave a... When you're hollowing out, you want to leave a little bit of meat towards the top because that's where the ornament's going to be hanging from. And you want that small finial to be able to hold up over years and years, hopefully, of hanging on a tree. I've got a cord hanging down here. I'm gonna kind of move out of the way. I think you got it. Maybe not. I think that'll do. Take a little bit more off towards the top. And she is pretty much done. So now I'll finish off the bottom, or the top of the ornament as it actually is. Get that nice bowl gouge again. You can use a spindle gouge, whatever you're comfortable with. I'm just so used to using this tool for almost everything nowadays, and it's a really versatile tool. So I'm going to start to cut. I'm going to do an overhead here. There we go. And take that blue block down a bit. Yep, it's a little bit of a tight. I'm gonna speed up the lathe a little bit more there. Oh, I got my handy magnet right there. Okay, so lose something in the shavings. And do just a. Scraping cuts here to match the shape on the front or the bottom of the piece. Yep, I'm just about there, but I can tell by the sound. So I'm gonna take my thin parting tool and I'm gonna turn down the speed a little bit here. Oh man, it broke out. Well, wasn't expecting that, darn it. But I do have some pre-made. So let me know in the chat if you guys want me to make another one or move on to the finials. Because I can go into production mode making the next, if I make another globe, so let's see what the chat says here. This lag time is really killing me. Oh, Doug, I got lots of wood in my shop. It's not spoiled, it's fresh. Well, not really fresh. I've got a couple of pieces of burl I've had in, big, giant pieces of burl. That I've had for since 2005 in my shop. I'm pretty sure it's pretty well and dry. Move on to the finial is fine. Okay, we got it. So we got other finials. I'll make a few finials here. Yeah, let's take this. I need the lock. Tail stock or the head stock here. I've got an opinions there saying finial, finials. No problem. So I'm going to put another chuck on. It has pin jaws in it. I like making the finials more than the globes. Because there's so many different design opportunities with the finials. Of course, with the globes, you can do all kinds of things. You can dye them. You can use SpectraPly to add color to it. You're just going to snug that up. See how true we're running. Go. Now, it's not all the way into the back of the chuck. I don't want it resting back there. All right. This is a piece of maple, silver maple. One by one. Let's see what shot we got. We're still on the overlay. My head's getting in everybody's way today. All right. So the first thing I need is my small roughing out gouge. It's like 3/4 of an inch between the flutes. So I got that all trued up, and we're gonna get this rounded down, the first thing. Turn it up just a little more till the vibration goes away. Turn it down a little bit. There we go. I'm at about 2,500 RPM. Perfect. All right, so I need to square off the end here. Come on. Come on. Back up. There we go. Do a couple of peeling cuts here all the way up to the chuck. So I'm going to start just sort of making a cone shape towards the end here. I'm standing back away from the lathe just a little bit more than usual, so I don't want my big old hairy head to get in your way of seeing what I'm doing here. You want to leave as much mass as you can. We're just going to bring that down to a nice point here without trying to break it off. All right, I'm just going to take a little more off of this. Now, I don't like using a tailstock when making finials, as it actually hinders the process. Puts a little bit pressure onto the piece, and it can actually cause a little of a bit of a bend in it while you're turning it, and your finials don't come out all that well when you do that. So, all right, so I'm going to grab a larger half-inch detail gouge. I'm gonna turn my chuck or my tailstock a little bit closer. Bring that down a little bit. Just bring it this. You can hear it's the wood is screaming at me because it doesn't like what I'm doing to it. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start on straight up and down and just give it a twist right into that. Right there. And we get a nice little taper into that point. I'm going to make an onion, what's called an onion-shaped finial for this. You guys can see what's going on pretty well. And I'm just going to slice into the wood just a little bit here. You got a little more detail here. Sort of a small bead here that I'll clean up with some sandpaper. It's easier to turn it around sandpaper than trying to do it with a small detail gouge. Going to go a little bit thinner here. I know you're asking, how thin can he go? Pretty thin, darn it. All right. So I'm going to stop for a minute, check the chat, and see if you guys got any questions. Now's the time to ask them. That'll see if there'll any pop up today. See anything coming up yet? But I'm just going to grab a little bit of a light sandpaper here, and some 400, help shape that bead a little bit. Wow, no questions yet? All right, well, we'll just keep on moving then. All right, I got a little bit of a chip out on that, so I'm going to grab my little, much smaller detail gouge. I'm going to clean that chip, that little part up real quick. I didn't realize that was there. All right, raise up my... Backed off my tailstock just a little bit, or my tool rest. There we go. This is a very small detail gouge that Doug Thompson makes. I love his tools. And they're a little deeper. Famous last words, right? That one last perfect cut, that's all you. And we'll see if I got that cleaned up enough to sand. Oh yeah, looks much better. All right, I'm gonna turn down the speed a bit. Take some 400 here. You don't need to really, I don't really go through all the grits when it comes to finials. So I'm going to do a little bit of a cleanup here. It's a little skew chisel. Yeah, I can see that puppy bending now. Just give that detail a little more sharper, crisp look to it. All right. Some more sand in here. It's best to do the sanding while before you get all the way to the end, because this finial will get really, really flexible on you. Yeah, we're doing good on time. Yep. Okay. It's too high. Still a little too high. If you got it too high, what happens is you're lifting the handle up and the finial will actually, the wood will actually ride up and snap off your tool. So let's continue on doing the shape all the way down. No, it's not going to be that big of an onion. I'm just going to gotta mark my spot. Where I want the finial onion to end. All hear the wood squeaking a little bit under the tool. Need to lower the tool rest just a hair more. Yeah, that should be better. Grab some sandpaper here. Drop it, speed down a notch. Clean that up a little bit. I ain't gonna do too much. This is a demo piece here. All right, so we're gonna move on to the rest of the piece. That in, smooth that cut up. And we're just going to make a nice little cove here. And we're just going to cut in right there. We're going to put a nice little cove right here. And so I'm going to measure that hole in that one globe I've got here, some calipers. And I always do this for each globe. Though I drilled the 5/8 hole there, sometimes the palming tools will rub on that opening and enlarge it just a little bit. So what I need this for, so I can put a tenon right in there using a small, that's not what I want, small parting tool. And I'm gonna bring my tailstock right up there. Do a nice trim in there. I think that one's a little dull. Luckily I have two. That's much better. All right, so I'm gonna raise my tool rest up a little bit here. And we're going to clean this up after I make the tenon a little bit. And I'm going to grab my calipers. Just a hair. It doesn't need to be super snug when it goes into the ornament. In fact, you want it to be a little loose, just in case the wood decides to expand a little bit. And there we go. I'm get my small detail gouge here. And just clean this up a little bit. It's got a little bit of a chip out. Clean up that little cove. And I'm gonna come back with that small parting tool. I'm gonna undercut this section right here, so it sits flat on the bottom of the ornament before you glue it. That always happens. I'll clean that up There we go. Back to the small detail count, kind of took a little too much wood off there doing that. And that tool was dull. I thought I had everything sharpened, but I didn't. So I'm going to grab another piece of that sandpaper. Do a real quick rub on there. And I'm going to grab that small parting tool again. I'm going to part this off. Oh man, am I really covering this whole thing? Sorry guys. And we've got our finial. Right there. If you take that globe, it fits pretty nice right in there. Just like that. Nice looking. So now I'm going to do the top finial. I'm going to bring this piece of wood out just a little bit. In there pretty good. And where are we? 10 minutes. We are pretty much on time, and I'll be able to answer some questions at the end of this. So I'm going to take this small part, roughing out gouge again. Turn up the speed some. Not that much. Peeling cuts. And we're going to do the same thing here. We're going to bring this down to a point. Switch over to my larger detail gouge. And I need to leave a little bit of a flat spot right there so I have a place to put the hook. I'm going to take my small parting tool, put a nice little divot in there again. And then we're going to do some fancy stuff here. Kind of a small OG curve on that part. Take this down a little bit. Looks a little heavy. There we go. Caught the jaws. Getting close to those jaws. You gotta be careful. It's about done. I'm taking a very, very small drill bit here, as you can see. My vice grips here. My vice chuck. Just gonna put a small hole in there, my little eye hook. And now, I need to do is measure that small hole. And we're gonna start taking away that those little parts here to pretty close. You're right on the money. So I'm just gonna take my little detail gouge, clean this up just a little bit. I'm just gonna put a back curve on it. Pretty interesting. Knew I forgot to get something out of my cabinet. Just a second here. Get my eye hooks. Got a whole bunch of these. Several of these. Different colors. This is an antique brass look. And we're just going to slip it right in there. And now we can part it off. I'm gonna undercut this just a hair if I can. Just a little bit, doesn't take much. So it sits flat on the top of the globe. Okay, and this one's so small, I just get it down to a point where I can just twist it off, since nobody's gonna see that part anyway. Go back to the face camera here. And we will put these two together. It's not glued, but there we go. We've got a ornament for the ages. You know, family members can pass that down. Hopefully you'll enjoy it for many years to come. So that's my heirloom ornament. So if anybody's got any questions for the next 10 minutes, I'm here to answer them. So I'm watching the chat right now. I'm glad all of you are able to join in and watch. This crazy hair of mine keeps getting in my face, but what are you gonna do? So Cameron's up next. I hope you guys stay tuned on this wonderful day and give him a watch. I'm not sure what he's gonna be making, but thank you for the good comments. I'm glad you like it. That was not a production thing. This was kind of a live thing, so my nerves are just a little on edge. I'm gonna grab a drink of water so I can keep talking. I've never done this before live on YouTube, so I hope you all enjoyed it. Oh, thank you. I'm glad you guys liked it. Any questions? What's the best wood for doing this? Well, I would stick with light woods. It's not really a per se what kinds are best and what are not. And here's a nice piece of spalted wood right here. These make beautiful ornaments. I've used Spectraply, all types. And as you can see, sometimes I'll paint them up with, this is milk paint. And then I'll sand off little parts of it, make it look a little bit worn, like it's been in the family for a long time, just getting passed down to pass down. And these are some of my favorites where I leave the bark on. These are really, really great. Oh man, this is so different from Zoom. I'm not used to being able to hear you guys talk back at me and seeing all your wonderful faces out there. I really like doing the Zoom demos. In fact, I have one this afternoon for our local wood turning club down in Southern California, the Ventura Wood Turners, or the Channel Island Wood Turners in Ventura. And that one's gonna go a bit longer, short on time here for an hour. So the one this afternoon will probably go two and a half hours long. So hopefully I'll be able to jump in the bed, take a short nap, because I was out here till 2 o'clock last night, making sure everything was gonna work. Looks like it did. Okay, soft, hard, exotics, local wood. Well, for the finials, I like to use a maple, a hard maple. It tends to take the details better. I've also used red cedar and walnut for that. Well, here's one with it has a walnut finial on it. Not sure how well you guys can see that. The only thing, well, people like them, but when you hang them on the tree with all the green, it kind of gets hidden in there. So that's why I like to try to use the lighter types of wood. And when you're making your blanks, you can do either or here. Like sometimes if I got a long spindle of wood, I'll actually put it on the lathe and turn it round and then slice it on my bandsaw. So it saves a little time when it comes to putting it on the lathe when you're doing production work overall. But there's no hurt in doing a square blank on a glue block too. That's what I did earlier. And I blew the bottom out. If you can, or the top, actually I got a little bit too thin. Which is all right. I mean, it happens. It happens more than you think sometimes. Sometimes you just have a bad day and it's like every 10th ornament you're making, it does this. Some days it doesn't do anything except perfection, which is I'm always striving for here in my shop. So, I hope I didn't talk too much or I didn't talk enough. Not sure. Thank you for all the wonderful comments. I just wish my shoulder one wasn't it. I thought I had that in the right position, and man, that was just blocking everything. So I hope you guys have a wonderful day. And it looks like all the questions are done, so stay tuned for Cameron's. Switch over to his channel, watch his demo. And I think I'm gonna probably call it a morning, so everybody has a chance to jump over there before Cameron starts, all right? So thank you very much for joining. I'm not sure where everybody is around the world. Thank you, Carl. I'm glad you approve. That means a lot to me. And this latency thing between my shop and YouTube, it's just kind of crazy. So, all right. So I'm going to sign off. Enjoy a little bit more Christmas music as I close out my morning. And hopefully I'll see you soon. Hopefully in a live demo at your club. I'm open to that. I'm also, as you can tell, doing remote demos. So if you guys want to just email me, you see it down there at the bottom of my screen. If your club or somebody is interested in doing a Zoom demo or something else like this on YouTube, just give me a shout and we can work something out that's makes everybody happy. All right, so I'm going to sign off now. You guys take care. We'll see you next time.
I don't want a lot for Christmas. There is just wish I knew. All I want for Christmas is you.
Christmas, there is just one thing I need,
and I
don't care about the
I don't want a lot for Christmas.